see what happened to these eyes? Do you see what happened to my beautiful blonde hair? The amount of shit I have to watch through the past week just to deliver you the best content on the planet is unimaginable.
So, like this video and subscribe to my channel even before you watch this video, cause this video got a YouTube seal of approval. So it must be really good, right? I'm Frank Reed, everybody, and let's roll.
He is so blatantly, obviously, and totally incompetent.
So I've noticed a certain trend recently, and I feel like more people should be aware of it. Have you noticed how the position of President of United States of America has become a contest of, hey, can you find the worst person to do this? Because after Barack Obama, the American people have got Donald Trump, and that's a...
It's a controversial person.
Eh, fuck it. This is not family-friendly content anyway. He's a clown. He's a fucking clown. I'm sorry to say that. You guys got fucked. You, reasonable American citizens, you just got fucked. And after the day Donald Trump was elected, I feel like half of the planet asked themselves a question. Am I living in a simulation?
You just got pranked, bro!
And when people thought it just can't get any worse, out of nowhere...
As you probably could have guessed by this moment, I have decided in 2020 to run for president.
Kanye West, everybody. Kanye West, 2024 US president. Kanye West.
Yo. Yo.
This is dope, dude.
So have you started seeing that trend already? We went from a politician, to a businessman, to a rapper. And guess who's next? In case this actually happens, you guys have heard it here first. So let me proudly announce, the 2028 candidate for US president, a porn star, Riley Reed.
I've sucked off my Uber driver.
She would also become a first woman in the history to become a US president.
She's doing it.
This is amazing.
How to properly tag your YouTube videos. Okay, so I actually watch videos like this because as a YouTuber, people will always tell you, oh, you have to do this for passion, don't care about the views. But that's completely not true. You spend hours upon hours on a single video, so you kind of want to get some views, right? It works as like sort of gratification for hours put into a video. So I've been trying to come up with some ideas to get better reach because, let's be honest. And I came up with a couple options, like, for example, I could talk about current dramas, but...
Hello darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly creeping.
Yeah, let's not do that. But if I don't want to talk about dramas, I can make them. And I'm trying to. But Felix hasn't responded yet. I could also try utilizing current trends, like tier lists, for example. Like JoJo Stan tier list, or JoJo character list, or JoJo Stan tier list Golden Wind, or JoJo Star tier list JoJolion, or JoJo openings and endings tier list, or JoJo villain power tier list, or JoJo dad tier-
You people have a fucking problem.
So how about we make something that no one has ever made before? A tier list of seasons. Summer's shit, it lands in D tier. Deadly hot temperatures, all sorts of annoying insects, and unforgettable public transport adventures.
But Frank, you can do something about the hot temperature. You can go to a pool.
Oh shit, what a great idea. You had that idea and 9,000 other people had it too. Yeah, fuck summer. Okay, let's move on. Next up we have fall, and fall is a solid B tier. Cause you have those beautiful colors all around. You have Halloween parties, there's good food, mushrooms, minus for the obnoxious amounts of cinnamon added to literally every
single thing.
Regardless, cool season, nothing against it, let's move on. Winter's awesome, it's like a very high A tier. You can go skiing, you can go snowboarding, you can make a snowman. It's cold and it's beautiful and Christmas, everyone likes Christmas. The only reason winter doesn't land in S tier is that as the sun disappears, so does my will to live. Spring's a tough one. This, I'm just recording on a different day. But back to the matter of fact, spring's a tough one because there's so many amazing things about spring. Like, everything becomes green, it's beautiful, the temperature is perfect, and you want to do so many things and you want to hang out with so many people. And at the same time, you really don't want to hang out because everyone keeps talking about their allergies. Oh hey man, what's up? How's your family?
Oh, they're doing fine, but me? I have constant allergies. Like, I'm coughing, I'm sneezing, I'm basically dying here.
Well, it's good your family's doing well, at least. Listen, how about that project we were talking about? How about we just make it happen, like, a week from now?
Oh yeah, let's do that, man. I'm really excited about it. I would be so much more excited, though, if it wasn't for those damn allergies and the fact that I have to cough and sneeze and then I'm basically dying.
Sorry to hear that. Listen, how about we just take it easy and we just chill and play video games?
Oh man, I totally would do that if it wasn't for those damn allergies and the fact that I have to sneeze and—
Shut the fuck up! There's medicine for it! Go to a pharmacy and buy medicine for it! It's not vaccines, it doesn't cause autism! Five types of people that piss me— You know who pisses me off? People who try to show off their confidence in the most obnoxious ways. Case in point, I was at this party recently and there was this guy that clearly had some sort of serious insecurity. I mean, everyone was sitting normally, but this guy... And you know, normal everyday handshakes, right? But this guy... And here's a useful tip on how to deal with those assholes. When they let go of your hand, look at it for a second, and then look them right in the eyes. And don't let go of the eye contact. They will feel so fucking awkward, they will never dare to do this shit again. It's time for a new segment in our little series. Let's hop onto the YouTube trending tab for some more content. KSI versus Logan Paul. Oh yeah, I remember that match from a year ago. The build-up and those conferences, those interviews, there was so much hype about it. And then they entered the ring. It was a scam. I have no idea how people forget about that so quickly. Like, why are we getting hyped over this? Last year they fucking scammed you. But since we're on the topic of celebrity freak fights, you still have a ton to learn from Poland. Because you can say whatever you want about Poland. That we're basically Russians, that we're not as advanced technologically as the West, but there's one thing that we do fantastically, and that's our celebrity fights. Because a freak fight in Poland is not some, like, two buff YouTubers fighting in a boxing match. No. A freak fight in Poland is an underage boy fighting a midget in a cage to death.
This is dope, dude.
Okay, that last part is not really true, but let's just move on. My mom said if I didn't turn the volume down, she smashed my head against the... Practice being funny. Just stop writing comments under videos. Pro-vaccine versus anti-vaccine. Should your kids get vaccinated? You know what's the worst thing about like flat earthers, anti-vaxxers, climate change skeptics? Idiots in general. Because there's this worldwide trend of accepting people and being respectful, we end up in a situation where these people are treated seriously.
Vaccines are all made the same and they're all safe and healthy and good for you, that everybody's benefiting from it, because that's false. It's
not
true.
But we study them before we release them to the public. We study them so we do know they're safe. La la la.
La la la. Why are these people even trying to— Stop. Just stop it. Stop. Stop talking to them. Just throw them in a zoo with monkeys and see how well they're getting along.
Am I the only one who hates PewDiePie?
Okay, my man, I'm gonna be completely honest with you, okay? Fully transparent, not gonna beat around the bush, just gonna get straight to the point. You're dumb as fuck. You seem like a person that orders pizza with friends and the delivery guy is a little late. It happens. So you know the pizza's gonna be cold and you open the pizza box and the mozzarella is molding. The cheese is fucking molding. So you call the pizzeria and you go, "Hi,
I ordered a pizza an hour ago, and it arrived cold.
Cause let's be honest, as much as I like to poke fun at Felix, I don't think his content is that bad. Or it's not harmful in any way, it's just really lazy.
What a fucking nick.
But if you really think his content is that bad, I have some bad news for you. Cause there's people out there who watch the Cut channel on daily basis.
With their consent, reveal your penis to your opponent. Let them critique it for a minute.
Oh, by the way, and here's the dating advice for all of you people looking for love. When you're on the first date, ask the other person what are they watching on YouTube. Legit advice, by the way. It's a good way to get to know each other better. But if you see that they are watching something like The Cut...
Okay, how many people have stuck their penis in your vagina?
Go to the bathroom and escape through the window. After 4 hours, when they're closing, you will most likely get a message.
Hey, it's taking you a while. Are you okay there?
Okay, so that does it for this episode. Thank you very much for watching. Here's the social media, and I'll see you soon.